Corporate nationalists to consolidate resources to oppose GOP election reforms. This is our top stories report. And our top link we're showing here for this top stories report is major corporations plan to oppose election integrity measures. This is almost a topic report, this story alone, but I ended up not choosing it. From the Daily Caller, Michael Ginsberg, this is the excerpt. The leaders of over 100 major corporations spoke via Zoom on Saturday about how they could combat election integrity laws, similar to the one passed in Georgia, according to multiple reports. This is corporate nationalists flexing their recently discovered muscle. Now that they can have the arena, if you will, thanks to basically the DNC finding usefulness in corporate nationalism, they're now open about their willingness to use their considerable corporate national power to influence the American democratic system at a level that we human beings, we poors, could never even imagine approaching. And they're all of one heart and one mind when it comes to this. Now, make no mistake, as I've said before, they're aligned right now, but if and when they actually succeed in destroying the American poor's ability to have any sense of self and associative sovereignty, then they'll turn on each other. But until then, they're all of one mind. They're like the Book of Acts, upside down Book of Acts, when they all got together and one heart and one mind. But the heart and one mind of the Book of Acts is rested in Christ, and the heart and one mind of the corporate nationalist is represented in the heart of the earth, which is rule through death, and as opposed to rule through life. Continuing on with our top stories report, we have California city puts fence around restaurant where owner won't stop serving despite lockdown. This is from independent.co.uk. An excerpt from it: a restaurant in Burbank, California that repeatedly violated COVID safety protocols was fenced in by authorities in a bid to prevent people from entering the area. From movies.yahoo.com, we have Elon Musk's new Las Vegas underground transport system compared to a crappy Disney ride. I don't know why they had to, like, crappy is a horrible word. I don't get it. From California Movies, well, let's just see real quick what they have to say here. So Elon Musk is essentially driving cars underground for a mile and calling it innovation. You could go and see Thunderfoot videos on this to get the lowdown on it, and you'll have yourself a good laugh. Elon Musk's new Las Vegas underground transport system, there it is. And Kim Jong-un executes official after he launches extraordinary rant against government. This is from, I believe, well, I thought it was Newsweek, but it's not. It's Express UK. And then we have China officials acknowledge low effectiveness of the country's COVID vaccines from New York Times. USA stimulus checks continue. So far, 74 congressional lawmakers have pushed for recurring checks until the end of the pandemic from this is from, well, let's see where this is from. It says Reddit, but it's really, Reddit is always just a link here. Now that's the Newsweek link. All right, there you go. And then finally we have Don't Fight the Fed, Goldman says these stocks can benefit from higher inflation.